Hi there, I'm Heather Gill, local realtor here in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, and today I am talking with Lori Van. She is the owner of Van & Associates here in town, and they do coaching, counseling, and consulting. Lori, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for inviting me.
Absolutely. You know, so on TexasElder.care, we had a question come in, and I think you can really help us out with this one. What do you do if there are unresolved issues from the past with your aging parent? Can you speak to this for us?
Yes. Oh, boy, this brings up so many different things for individuals when they're facing their loved one going towards those final days. And there's all the what ifs and I would is and I should is and I could is. And regret is a horrible thing to have.
Yeah, so I
do encourage individuals that if it's emotionally safe, because there are some individuals that, you know what, no matter what, it's just not going to be an emotionally safe situation to do this in. But collect your thoughts. I really encourage individuals to do a letter to that individual that may be getting ready to pass on and write out a lot of those thoughts, those feelings, those regrets, and even things of, you know what, this actually really bothered me and this is part of my closure, you know, too. Never go with the first draft, maybe never even go with the second draft, but it's a starting point of one, you being able to process all of the stuff that maybe you've been tucking away and avoiding.
Right.
It's good on that level. But then, and this is, you know, where counseling can help assist a person putting together a letter such as this to come up with what are going to be the main objectives of going to that individual and getting that closure. And maybe it's you have to ask them for forgiveness. Maybe it's you would love for them to ask you for forgiveness, but understanding that at least you can know you've put out there and say, you know what, yes, this did hurt me. And even though this happened 20 years ago or whatnot, it's, you know what, I'm in a place where I forgive you and that I want you to be able to go in peace. So those are a couple of different options. Now, some individuals may have already gone into that hospice care situation and they're not able to respond. It's something you can still do because we know that individuals, even in that state, are still hearing what's going on in that environment. And that still, if it's a letter of closure and providing that peace and possibly that forgiveness of the individual, they're hearing it and it's going to help them.
Yeah.
So those are just a couple of quick ideas.
So Lori, those are definitely some good practical tips for somebody who's dealing with this kind of issue. And I mean, and unfortunately, just the world we live in, there's a lot of, you know, kids that harbor some kind of issue with their parents, vice versa too. I mean, and it's not a bad idea to just sit down and write out those feelings and thoughts and just get it off your chest. And hey, I love your tip there. Don't do the first draft. Okay. That's probably a really good idea for most things we do in life. I mean, heaven knows I've sent some emails and I'm like, I probably should have read that again.
So definitely. Yeah. I mean, social media is a really great example of that. Of, you know what, just maybe pause and give yourself that extra minute to just read back through that post before you hit click.
Right. No, for sure. I think that would benefit all of us regardless, you know, regardless of the situation. So, you know, if y'all have additional questions for Lori and her team, if you're looking for additional help, she's happy to help any way she can. Her number's there on the screen and you can also reach her with her email address there. Lori, thank you again for your time.
You're very welcome.